Last, we were speaking about, we had finished about the impaction. We spoke about the definition of impaction. We talked about the indications why we have to remove impaction, mandibular temporal impaction. And also we spoke about the reasons, what are the causes which can cause the impaction. That is some of the theories we had spoken about in the last class. Today, we will be talking about the classification of mandibular temporal impaction. What is the importance of classification? Whenever classification is there, it is going to help you to have a common platform for you to discuss with your colleagues. So also, even you talk about if it is a mesoangular impaction, the other person also will get to know what is a mesoangular impaction or a distoangular impaction. So that is the main importance of classifications. So when we coming about the classification part, we have mainly been followed two classifications which are more important. That is, one is Winters classification and Pellen-Gregory's classification. Of course, we have other classification also. So now we'll start with the Winters classification. So in the Winters classification, what do you have? It was given by Winters in the year 1926. So according to this, it is based mainly on the angulation of the third molar in relation to the second molar. So according to that, what we have, it has been classified into mesoangular, horizontal, vertical, distoangular, lingoangular, angular and inverted. I will be showing you the picture of those, how it happens. This may also happen simultaneously, buccal version, lingual version, proximal version. That is, the tooth as a whole can be on the buccal side or it can be on the lingual side. So how does it classification? This is the representation of the classification. These are angular impaction. These are angular impaction. You can see over here that is, you can see that it is angular. This is long axis of the second molar and then the long axis of the third molar, which is then it is easily tilted. So according to this, can be called as a mesoangular impaction. And then when you talk about the horizontal impaction, it's almost at a 90 degree to the long axis of the second molar. So you can see that then we call it as a horizontal impaction. So when you talk about the vertical impaction, when you draw a line on the long axis of the second molar and draw a line along the long axis of the third molar, it's parallel to each other. Then we can call it as a vertical impaction. And then we have a distoangular impaction. Most of the time what happens is you have a confusion between vertical impaction and a distoangular impaction. So how do you find out about the difference? Because the difficulty in the removal, surgical removal, mainly depends on the type of impaction. So how are we going to find out about which is a vertical and which is the mesoangular, and vertical is the representation between the roots, the distance between the roots, which is going to tell you about the is it a mesoangular or a vertical or a distoangular. Looking at the x-rays also, we can easily find out. So how are we going to learn the mesoangular? What happens is the distance between the distal root of the second molar and the mesial root of the third molar is greater than the distance between the distal root of the first molar and the mesial root of the second molar. And when you talk about, when you see about the vertical impaction, that both are equal. And when you talk about the distoangular impaction, the space between the mesial root of the third molar and the distal root of the second molar is less when compared to the distance between the distal root of the first molar and the second molar. It is clearly seen in the picture. You can just visualize it. I hope you can understand that. Now coming to the Pellen-Gregory classification, this is another part of classification. It was given by Pellen-Gregory in 1933. According to that, we decide the classification is based on the position of the third molar in relation to the second molar and what level it is present. Is it present at the level of the crown, or is it level at the cervical part or below the cervical part? So according to that, we can classify it as position A, position B, and position C. When we talk about position A, that means the tooth. When you draw a line around the opposite plane of the first and the second molar, posteriorly, it is almost at the level. It is at the level, the cusp of the third molar, or a part of the cusp of the third molar, will be at the level or above the level of this line. Then we call it as a position A. So when we talk about position, what happens is here, again you can see in the picture that it is at the lower level, but it is above the cervical line. So when you draw a line above on the opposite plane and you have the cervical line and the upper part of the crown or the cusp is in between the crown and the cervical line of the second molar, then we call it as the position B. When we talk about the position C, it's below the
cervical line. So it is called as position C is below the cervical iris. This will be one of the most difficult type of impaction because it will be inside the bone and we need to cut lot of bone in that. Now, part 2 of this phalangeal classification is based on the relationship of the two to the anterior part of the radius of the mandible and the distance. This is the main, the major distance. Second molar we take into consideration. When you have the mesial distal pit of the tooth is less than the distance between the anterior part of the ramus to the distal surface of the third molar, then we, if you have enough of space, then we call it as a class 1 type of impaction, that is Phalangeal classification, class 1. And then if the distance, the mesial distal distance is less when compared to the distance between the anterior part of the ramus to the distal part of the second molar, then we call it as a class 2 type of impaction, and when the tooth is inside the ramus, we call it as a class 3 type of Phalangeal classification. So this is the other classification.